The magazine, too, is presented by Catherine Graham and Yves Loisel.
Bonjour, mesdames.
Bonjour, mesdemoiselles.
Bonjour, messieurs.
Voici Ensemble magazine numéro 2.
This is the second of our three extra holiday programs, and in it we'll be having some more pronunciation practice, we'll be answering some of the letters you've sent us, and at the end of the program, there's another episode of our serial Les Aventures de Clémentine.
And we'll have time to do some extra revision work, which this week is on the theme of the time of day. And in fact, we start with telling the time.
Do you remember the difference between how to ask when and how to ask what time?
For when, the word is quand.
But when you ask quand, the answer could be 7:30, or last week, or 6:50. If you want to narrow it down to the time of day, you ask quelle heure, what time. How would you ask what time is it?
Quelle heure est-il?
Now, what are people going to answer? They'll start with il est. That's like it is. Then say the time. Here are a few examples, and you repeat them. Il est 3 heures.
Il est 6 heures.
Il est 11 heures.
Il est 6h30.
That's how you say 6:30. 6h30. You try saying it's 11:30.
Il est 11h30.
Now, the word for quarter is quart, and quarter past is écart. So how would you say it's 11:15?
Il est 11h15.
If you want to say it's 1/4 to the hour, the words to use are moins le quart, moins le quart. Try saying it's 11:45.
Il est 11 heures moins le quart.
Remember one thing. You'll find people use the 24-hour clock quite a lot in France, especially when it's something public, like train or plane times or the opening hours of shops. And we recorded somebody telling the time with a 24-hour clock in Dijon.
Annick Magnier went to a cinema and spoke to the woman in the booking office to find out when the performances were. A performance is une séance. Une séance.
First of all, she asked how many performances there were. Combien de séances?
Il y a combien de séances?
How many performances per day?
Il y a combien de séances par jour? Écoutez.
Madame, s'il vous plaît, il y a combien de séances par jour?
Eh bien, il y a en principe 5 séances par jour.
Et à quelle heure sont ces séances?
Les séances débutent à 14h, 16h, 18h, 20h et 22h et 24h le samedi.
The first performance is at 2 p.m.
À 14h.
And the others?
À 16h, à 18h, à 20h et à 22h.
And there is an extra midnight showing on Saturdays.
Et le samedi à 24h. Listen to the woman in the cinema again and see if you can work out how many showings there are on Sundays.
Eh bien, il y a en principe 5 séances par jour.
Et à quelle heure sont ces séances?
Les séances débutent à 14h, 16h, 18h, 20h et 22h et 24h le samedi.
Et le dimanche?
Alors, le dimanche, les séances sont normales.
On Sunday, there are 5 performances. Not the midnight one, that's only on Saturdays.
How much does a seat cost?
A seat is une place. Combien coûte la place?
Combien? Écoutez.
Combien coûte la place?
En principe, elle est à 9,50.
9,50.
9 francs 50. 9 francs 50.
Ça, c'est pour les tarifs normaux.
Yes, that's the regular price. Le tarif normal. But some people can get in for less.
Il y a des tarifs réduits. Écoutez.
Combien coûte la place?
En principe, elle est à 9,50 pour les tarifs normaux et 7 francs pour les tarifs réduits. Mm?
7 francs pour les tarifs réduits. Of course, if you want a cut price seat, you have to have a student card, or else you must be over 65.
Now listen to that recording again. Concentrate on the times and the prices.
Madame, s'il vous plaît, il y a combien de séances par jour?
Eh bien, il y a en principe 5 séances par jour.
Et à quelle heure sont ces séances?
Les séances débutent à 14h, 16h, 18h, 20h et 22h et 24h le samedi.
Et le dimanche?
Alors, le dimanche, les séances sont normales.
Combien coûte la place?
En principe, elle est à 9,50 pour les tarifs normaux et 7 francs pour les tarifs réduits.
Unfortunately, everything doesn't happen on the stroke of the hour. So you'll need to be able to say 10 past, 22, and so on. For times past the hour, you just add on the number of minutes. So for instance, 5 past 2 is
2h05.
And 5 minutes later than that,
2h10.
5 minutes later,
2h15.
And what's 5 minutes after that? You try saying it.
Deux heures vingt.
For minutes to the hour, you say moins. 5 to 2.
2 heures moins cinq.
5 minutes earlier than that is, well, what is it?
Deux heures moins dix.
And so on. And one other thing. Just as in English, there is more than one way of saying what the time is. 10 to 6 or 5:50. The same applies in French.
5h50
or 6h-10.
Now, if you're in France, you might want to know when shops, garages, museums and so on are open. And it's always useful to know when banks are open.
When is the bank open? Now, you could simply say, quand est-ce que la banque est ouverte? S'il vous plaît.
Or you could be more precise and ask from what time, till what time, de quelle heure à quelle heure. La banque est ouverte de quelle heure à quelle heure, s'il vous plaît.
That's what Jean asked Monsieur Genin, the manager of a large bank in the center of Dijon.
And he got a very precise answer. Écoutez.
Monsieur Genin, la banque est ouverte de quelle heure à quelle heure?
La banque est ouverte le matin de 8h20 à 12h10 et l'après-midi de 14h20 à 17h45.
Le matin, la banque ouvre à 8h20.
8h20, 8:20, 20 past 8. 8h20.
How would you say 10 past 12? Dix. That's when they close for lunch.
So, la banque est ouverte de 8h20 à 12h10 le matin.
Et l'après-midi? La banque ouvre l'après-midi à 14h20.
14h20. 14:20. 2:20. 14h20. And when does it close?
La banque ferme à 17h45.
17h17. That's 5 p.m. 17h45, 5:45. Listen to that again, and this time you'll also hear which days the bank is open.
La banque est ouverte le matin de 8h20 à 12h10 et l'après-midi de 14h20 à 17h45.
Chaque jour?
Tous les jours de la semaine, sauf le samedi et le dimanche.
They are closed on Saturdays and Sundays, as in Britain.
Are the times the same for all banks?
More or less, but some stay open on Saturdays and close on Mondays.
Et est-ce que les horaires sont les mêmes pour toutes les banques?
Plus ou moins, mais quelques banques sont ouvertes le samedi, par contre fermées le lundi.
Monsieur Jeunin's opening times may have seemed rather unusual, but there is a reason behind it. If your office shuts at 12 and you want to go to the bank, you can, because it stays open till 10 past.
And if you have a shop and you reopen at 2:30, you can call in at the bank at 20 past to get some change.
And in case you have trouble finding a bank open when you're in France, here is a hint. If there is a market nearby, you can be pretty sure of finding a bank open as long as the market is. Now, why don't you try telling the time? Suppose you're waiting for the bus and a car stops. The driver wants to go to the post office. I'll tell you what to say.
Pardon, il y a un bureau de poste par ici, s'il vous plaît?
Yes, there is a post office on Place Victoria. Oui, il y a un bureau de poste, Place Victoria.
C'est loin?
No, it's not far. It's 5 minutes away. Non, non, ce n'est pas loin. C'est à 5 minutes.
Est-ce qu'il y a un parking?
Yes, there's a big car park. It's easy. Oui, il y a un grand parking. C'est facile.
Le bureau de poste est ouvert de quelle heure, s'il vous plaît?
It's open from 8:30 till 6 o'clock. Il est ouvert de 8:30 à 6:00.
Merci bien. Au revoir.
Say goodbye. Au revoir, monsieur. Still on the subject of time, Jean wanted to go from Dijon to Grenoble, and we recorded him at the station information desk when he went to ask about train times. He wanted to know about the next train to Grenoble.
Le prochain train pour Grenoble. Le prochain train pour Grenoble part à quelle heure?
It leaves at 11:46. Écoutez.
Pardon, monsieur, le prochain train pour Grenoble part à quelle heure, s'il vous plaît?
Le prochain train part à 11:46.
Is it non-stop?
Direct?
Il est direct?
Il est direct?
Il est direct pour Grenoble.
Non-stop to Grenoble. And what platform?
C'est à quel quai?
Et c'est à quel quai?
Au deuxième quai, monsieur.
Au deuxième quai.
Platform number two. At what time does the train get in?
À quelle heure?
À quelle heure il arrive à Grenoble?
À quelle heure il arrive à Grenoble?
À 15:05.
15:05. 15:05. 3:05. Apparently that's too early for Jean's liking. So he asks, isn't there a train later?
Il n'y a pas de train plus tard?
There certainly is. Écoutez.
Il n'y a pas de train plus tard?
Si, vous avez un train à 14:34 avec changement à Lyon-Perrache pour arriver à Grenoble à 17:33.
Merci.
You've got a train at 2:34, in other words, 14:34.
Vous avez un train à 14:34.
This one involves a change at Lyon. Perrache is the name of the main station there.
Vous avez un train à 14:34, mais avec changement à Lyon-Perrache.
And you arrive in Grenoble at 17:33. Vous arrivez à Grenoble à 17:33.
Vous avez un train à 14:34, avec changement à Lyon-Perrache, pour arriver à Grenoble à 17h33.
Jean thought he might be hungry, so he wanted to know if there was a restaurant car.
Est-ce qu'il y a un wagon-restaurant?
There is one on the first train, that's the 11:46. But the second only has a buffet car, a wagon-bar. Écoutez.
Est-ce qu'il y a un wagon-restaurant?
Le premier train possède un wagon-restaurant, le deuxième un wagon-bar.
Parfait, merci beaucoup.
À votre service, monsieur.
That recording was fairly complicated. Let's listen to it right through once more. If you want to look at the text, it's on page 112 in your book.
À la page 112.
Pardon, monsieur, le prochain train pour Grenoble part à quelle heure, s'il vous plaît?
Le prochain train part à 11h46.
Il est direct?
Il est direct pour Grenoble.
Et c'est à quel quai?
Au deuxième quai, monsieur.
À quelle heure il arrive à Grenoble?
À 15h05.
Il n'y a pas de train plus tard?
Si, vous avez un train à 14h34 avec changement à Lyon-Perrache pour arriver à Grenoble à 17h33.
Merci. Est-ce qu'il y a un wagon-restaurant?
Le premier train possède un wagon-restaurant, le deuxième un wagon-bar.
Parfait. Merci beaucoup.
À votre service, monsieur.
Now it's time for your questions. First of all, a general question about conversational style.
We had a letter from a listener in Swansea referring to the recordings we made in shops in Dijon and asking if French people really do spend so much time being so polite to each other.
They certainly do seem to be packed with bonjour monsieur and merci mademoiselle and au revoir madame.
And je vous en prie mademoiselle and je suis désolé monsieur and so on.
There's a quick answer to that question. Yes. People in France do tend to punctuate their conversation with these polite expressions, especially when the two people don't know one another. And it's not at all unusual for a conversation with a shopkeeper to end with voilà madame, merci madame, au revoir madame. And the thing is, it doesn't sound obsequious in French as it might in English.
So if in doubt, stick in an extra madame or monsieur, it can't do any harm. We've also had a number of comments about the music you hear at the beginning of each program. Some people like it, others don't. One listener asked why we didn't use some French music.
Well, in fact, it is French. Not as typically French as accordions or farandoles, but it is typical of France today. It's from the long play record La Révolution Française, the French Revolution, which is from a rock opera produced in Paris recently.
The track we took our signature tune from is called Le Tiers État, and the music is by Claude-Michel Schoenberg and Raymond Jeannot.
Here is part of another track from the Révolution Française album, La Déclaration des Droits de l'Homme et du Citoyen, the original Declaration of the Rights of Man, only in a rock version.
S'exprime par la loi, et la loi les protège et les punit.
Peuple blés, c'est bon-là, que ne parlez pas ce
And here is part of a rather on-rock number from the same show. The Dauphin and his little sister are playing in the park at the Royal Palace of Versailles. Little do they realize the significance of the 14th of July, 1789.
À Versailles, chaque jour, papa se retire pour faire des serrures dans son grenier. Allez, viens dans le parc, nous pourrons courir. Mais d'abord, je voudrais te dire un... Il paraît qu'à Paris, c'est la révolution. Il paraît
fais chaud, tu m'ennuies avec tes histoires. Tu verras quand je serai le roi. Pour l'instant, viens jouer à Colin Maillard. Je suis sûre que je cours bien plus vite que toi.
Ah, mon fils, vous voilà encore.
Let's get away from the revolution and try some pronunciation practice. Some people learning French have difficulty with the nasal vowels. Nasal vowels are vowels A, E, I, O, U, followed by a single N or M. And they're called nasal vowels because the N or M isn't pronounced itself. It gets absorbed into the vowel, which is pronounced partly through the nose.
You get a nasal vowel when there is one N at the end of a word, as in question.
Or when you have an M or N followed by a different consonant, as in impossible. There are basically three nasal sounds, un, en, and un. Try them. Un, un,
en, en.
And un. Un.
Now let's put them into words. What about the word for wine? Le vin.
Le vin. And the word for white? Blanc. Blanc.
If you're telling someone to watch out, you'll shout, attention. Attention. What about a nice bath? Un bon bain. Un bon bain.
Nice and hot, bien chaud. Un bon bain, bien chaud.
Or a nice white wine, un bon vin blanc. Un bon vin blanc. And now, to end today's program, Les Aventures de Clémentine. Last week, Catherine, on her way to an important meeting, got stuck in a traffic jam. She found a hen wandering about the streets and managed to get it into the car. Luckily, there was an identity disc, so she found out the hen belonged to the Duchesse de Sang-Froid, who lives in the Rue du Marché. This week, she's still driving round looking for Rue du Marché to get the bird back to the Duchess. Voici donc Les Aventures de Clémentine, épisode 2.
Oh, zut! Mon rendez-vous! Quelle heure est-il? 6h moins le quart! Et mon rendez-vous est à 6h! Oh, je vais téléphoner. Clémentine, vous attendez dans la voiture, ok? Bon, bon! Alors venez avec moi! Allez, vite! Dans le sac! Ouf, voilà. Maintenant, le téléphone. Ah, il y a un café, juste là.
Allô ?
Allô, Yves ?
Oui, c'est Catherine ?
Oui.
Mais où êtes-vous, Catherine ? Il est 6h moins 5.
Oui, mais j'ai un problème.
Qu'est-ce qu'il y a ? Un accident ?
Non, une poule.
Pardon ?
Une poule. Il y a une poule dans ma voiture.
Parlez plus fort, la ligne est très mauvaise.
Il y a une poule dans ma voiture.
Eh bien, c'est original. Quel genre de poule ?
C'est une petite poule blanche. Elle s'appelle Clémentine. C'est la poule de la duchesse de Sang-Froid.
Et elle est dans votre voiture maintenant?
Oui, enfin, non, elle est ici, dans mon sac. J'ai l'intention d'aller chez Madame de Sang-Froid avec la poule.
Bonne idée, c'est où?
Rue du Marché. Silence.
Comment?
Oh, non, pas vous Yves, Clémentine. Alors, je vais arriver à 6h30. Au revoir Yves. Ouf, j'ai besoin d'un café. Où est le garçon?
Madame, vous désirez? Pardon, madame?
Je voudrais un café, s'il vous plaît.
Ah oui, un café. Noir, crème, petit, moyen, grand?
Un grand café crème.
Entendu, madame.
Ah, patience, Clémentine. Le service est rapide.
Voici, madame, un grand café crème.
Ça fait combien?
2,50 francs, s'il vous plaît.
Voici.
Merci, madame.
Oh, monsieur, pour aller à la rue du Marché, s'il vous plaît.
Rue du Marché, vous allez tout droit, vous prenez la première rue à gauche, et au feu rouge, c'est la rue du Marché.
Alors, c'est tout droit, première à gauche, et au feu rouge, c'est la rue du Marché.
C'est ça, madame.
Merci, monsieur.
De rien, madame. Et voilà, c'est tout pour cette semaine.
Listen to the final program next week to find out what happens to Clémentine.
And Catherine. Au revoir.
Au revoir.
Ensemble Magazine, Programme 2, was presented by Catherine Graham and Yves Loisel. The script was by John Ross, and the producer is Alan Wilding. The third and last of the extra Ensemble holiday programmes can be heard on Thursday evening at 11 o'clock on Radio 4 VHF. And the main programmes of the Ensemble course begin again with Programme 11 on Sunday the 10th of January. And now a word for listeners who are planning to sit for the Ensemble Achievement Test, administered by the University of Cambridge Local Examination Syndicate. This test must be taken at a registered centre, and you should take or send the individual candidate's entry form, to be found at the back of Ensemble Book 1, to the registrar or secretary of your chosen test centre. The closing date for entries is the 13th of February. A list of test centres can be obtained by writing before the 31st of January to the University of Cambridge Local Examinations Syndicate, 17 Harvey Road, Cambridge CB1, 2EU. And you should enclose a stamped addressed envelope and state clearly that you would like a list of centres for the Ensemble Achievement Test. I'll give you that address again. It's the University of Cambridge Local Examination Syndicate, 17 Harvey Road, Cambridge CB1, 2EU. And there we end Study on 4 for this afternoon.